So you're not in fact there, but you're nearby, which is great. Jeff, great to have you with us. Let's talk about all this. We're joined by historian, professor at Princeton University, Julian Zelizer. CNN senior political analyst David Gergen is with us, CNN political analyst and Washington bureau chief for the Daily Beast, Jackie Kucinich, and professor of constitutional law at Tulane University, Stephen Griffin. David, let me start with you on this back and forth between President Trump and John McCain. There's several levels going on here. Number one, let's just get to Senator McCain's response, where he says he will continue to enforce his oversight responsibilities as chairman of Armed Services Committee. As the chair of Armed Services, as a sitting senator, is it within his rights, David, to comment on the success of failure of a military mission?
Absolutely. Absolutely. This is one of the most powerful positions in the Senate. It's vital to our national security. And we regularly have debates back and forth whether a raid or a particular military operation was a good idea or a bad idea. As I recall, Donald Trump made a huge point during the campaign why he thought the war against Iraq was so mistaken. Well, when Sean Spicer came out yesterday and said, when somebody gets killed like this and the critic speaks up, it does a disservice to the person who's been killed. Well, my goodness, what about the Iraq war and how he handled that? How about Benghazi, where Donald Trump went back and forth? And I think Donald Trump was right to be and have those arguments, but having said that, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. So I do think that it was absolutely within John McCain's purview, and it's legitimate. And the whole notion of trying to shut down your critics, as Sean Spicer did yesterday and as Trump is doing again today, is so antithetical to what everything America stands for in a robust, vibrant democracy.
Stephen, there's also the issue of shutting down your critics when you're actually not stating fact in order to do so. I mean, the president also tweeting this morning about Richard Blumenthal, the senator, saying that, that Judge Gorsuch said, that he was displeased and about the comments about the judiciary branch, alluding to what the president said about these judges. The president comes out and tweets that he's misrepresenting what Judge Gorsuch said, but Judge Gorsuch's own spokesman came out and said, nope, that's true, that's exactly what the justice said. What do you make of it?
Well, I make of it that Judge Gorsuch did speak up. He hasn't objected to it. This happened some 24 hours ago. His own team has confirmed it. I don't know why the president is questioning the veracity of that. I can understand why he's not pleased. I'm sure he's surprised that this is a man he's put forward and that expressed total faith in him. I'm sure he feels Gorsuch turned on him. But nonetheless, I also understand that Judge Gorsuch was in a dilemma. I mean, he is supposed to be having honest conversations, and this is pretty darn important when a president attacks the judiciary branch. So I think that probably Judge Gorsuch has gone up in the estimation of members of the Senate. He's gone down in the estimation of the White House.
And Stephen, if you can hear me, just as a constitutional law professor, weigh in on that.
Well, the thought that occurs to me is that the Trump administration's immigration ban is rapidly morphing into a much bigger constitutional battle and constitutional problem, and it's all because of the actions, avoidable actions, of the president himself. The president himself is creating a new controversy on top of the immigration controversy that he's already involved in, namely a controversy having to do with whether he's going to launch an attack on the independence of the judiciary, something where he's going to get bipartisan pushback. And I have the strong feeling that Judge Gorsuch's comments are widely shared on the federal judiciary. And the federal judiciary is ultimately something that President Trump is going to need to enforce really anything he wants to do. So it's as if President Trump is not getting any good legal advice.
Jackie, if we can, I want to go back to the back and forth, or really just the fourth that the president's having with Senator John McCain right now. And one aspect of what he said about Senator McCain, which he has said before, but he said Senator McCain has been losing so long, he doesn't know how to win. Adding this personal, attack in what is a discussion about a military operation where a Navy SEAL died. I don't think we should let that pass by lightly.
That's Donald Trump's MO. I'm not saying it's all right. I'm just saying that's what he does. He attacks people personally. I mean, we're talking about a man who said John McCain isn't a war hero or something to that effect, which is just absolutely false. And, you know, John McCain deserves, the utmost respect for his service, but Donald Trump just hasn't really thought so, and he doesn't like that John McCain consistently goes after him, not only for this but also on Russia. John McCain has been one of the most, and we heard that in his interview with Manu, he's been one of the most outspoken critics of Donald Trump's praise for Vladimir Putin. So this is a relationship that's only going to get worse. But I'll tell you, John McCain isn't going to stop speaking up. So Donald Trump's just going to have to settle in.
Julian Zelizer, to you as the historian, as the professor of presidential history on this panel, weigh in for us on when you've seen a divide like this before when it comes to personal attacks. We've many times under many, many presidents seen ideological divides and divides on policy, et cetera. But the personal attacks that we're seeing from the president against his fellow Republicans in Congress and vice versa on the president.
I think he's escalating this to a level we haven't seen. We've had very contentious relations. You know, Richard Nixon and the Democratic Congress had very little love for each other. Democrats were very vocal about what was wrong with the administration.
Yeah, but this is within this president's own party.
But President Trump has a tendency not just to attack his own party, but to do it in very personal levels, as he's doing with McCain. The question is, does he become his own worst enemy? As we see, Democrats don't look like they're going to line up right now for almost anything that the president sends their way. And so if he starts to undercut Republican support in the Senate for his policies, for his nominees, that will be a big problem for the White House.
I mean, if he loses Republican support on Capitol Hill, that is when you might see things like the House Oversight Committee with Jason Chaffetz actually, exerting oversight over the White House and the like. David Gergen, you've worked in a number of administrations, as we like to see. This morning, Kellyanne Conway, senior counselor to the president, went on TV basically saying that people should go buy Ivanka Trump merchandise. This has to do with the back and forth over Nordstrom's dropping her line, the president criticizing Nordstrom's. Kellyanne Conway went on TV this morning. Do we have that sound? Let's play a little bit of that sound if we can.
Just real quick before we talk about Ivanka and what she's going through now, I want to just ask you, did the president pick up the phone or did the judge pick up the phone, or did they speak yesterday after Senator Blumenthal came out with his comments?
I'm not going to comment on that. I could just tell you that the president is fully confident in Judge Gorsuch. Okay. And he's fully confident. I mean, look at this. Look at this new polling data from Morning Consult. This is pretty cool. Look at on the blue is how much people support what the president is doing. Keystone XL, Affordable Care Act, sanctuary cities, seven predominant countries from entering the U.S. I mean, this is what matters the most, because America is paying attention to the way he's communicating and connecting with them on the substance.
Right.
So,
go to Politico. It's a Politico Morning Consult poll if you want to get the details on that.
And a Quinnipiac poll shows that 91% of Republicans love Donald Trump.
They do. Basically, because he keeps his promises. Everybody's just shocked that a businessman is about accountability and deliver. But you asked about Ivanka. I visited with her yesterday. You know, this is a very successful businesswoman twice. Obviously, she's stepped away from it now, but in the past, she's helped to run her family's real estate empire. And on the side, she developed another fully unbelievably entrepreneurial, wildly successful business that bears her name. And I think she's gone from 800 stores to 1,000 stores or 1,000 places where you can buy. You can certainly buy her goods online. And she's just at a very good place. She's an incredibly confident, creative, talented woman who also supports her father's presidency and realizes that there are bigger issues that he's going to tackle. And if she decides, and it works for her family, she comes inside the White House here. She knows people like Dina Palamy will be working with her to help on women empowerment, women and girls. I do find it ironic that you've got some executives all over the internet bragging about what they've done to her and her line, and yet they're using the most prominent woman in Donald Trump's most prominent she's his daughter, and they're using her, who's been a champion for women empowerment, women in the workplace, to get to him. So I think people can see through that.
30
go
seconds.
Buy Ivanka's stuff is what I would tell. I'm gonna go get some on myself today.
All right, David Gergen, that last bit was what brought we honored to hear. Go buy Ivanka Trump stuff. Is that appropriate from a White House staffer at the White House?
Well, we've never seen it before that I can recall. and hawking the goods and the brands of a member of the family traditionally has been considered out of bounds. It crosses into lines. Listen, all of us are trying to be fair to the president. We're trying to find the things that he does that we can say, yes, he did a really good job on that. But sometimes it's a real struggle. Attacking the judiciary, attacking Senator McCain in a very personal, insulting way, hawking the goods of the daughter. I must tell you, I think all three are ill-advised in the White House. You think that some of the Republicans who spent time trying to shut down Elizabeth Warren might spend some time now trying to shut down some of the things that are coming out of this White House. I think they'd be better off. The country would be better off.
David Gergen, Jackie Kucinich, Stephen Griffin, Julian Zelizer, thank you all very much. Still to come for us, fierce winter weather hammering the East Coast.